shot set to kick off. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Game festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Fielded at the four. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Tackled at about the 27-yard line.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. Have moved them back.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on their own 27. He's going to try and scramble. And they make the stop around the 29-yard line. There before he stepped out of bounds.
That's just how they drew it up. When I talked to this coach earlier in the week, he thought he could take advantage of zone coverage by attacking the perimeter outside the hashes. That time, it was a corner route, and it got him the first down.
First and 10, ball on the 45. Bring him down at the 45. He's taken down right around the 40.
This is why it's so important to have success in running the football. It forces a defense to prepare for it, and then that creates chances on play action. They executed that one perfectly.
That makes it second and 10. From the 40-yard line, it's second down. The middle. Tackle made for the 38-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Quick pass. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Steps out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. Well, I thought they'd keep it on the ground here, but they go to the air and pick up the first down.
I think the defense thought they were going to the ground as well, and that's what let this guy get open for a split second and get the first down.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Throw's complete. He's got room to work. And he shoved out of bounds around the 19-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Down around the 11-yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive. Nice run there as they work the outside. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Throws it in a hurry. And he converts the extra point. So a 13-play, 71-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
TCU is lining up to kick this one off. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Navy staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
And he hits him hard at the 29. Gain of a yard by the fullback.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short gain.
Caught out in the open. And he's taken down around the 48-yard line. Is back and down he goes at the 40-yard line. He kept it himself and picked up a good looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From the 32-yard line, first down. Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room earlier with an injury, and unfortunately, it looks like he could be sitting out the rest of this one. He fights forward to about the 30.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
And they hit him in the backfield.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. Kirk, good news. The guy that we saw go to the locker room with that injury earlier is back on the sideline, and I got to bet he's going to be back in the game soon. The cavalry's coming. Quick throw caught by the fullback. Tackle around the 31-yard line. We played one. TCU in front, 7-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. It has the distance, and he splits the uprights.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
7-3, TCU. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 22-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. TCU is up 4. He's tackled at the 45-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. from there. Out to about the 48-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Here's the handoff, and he's brought down right away. So the toss to the halfback doesn't work. That's a loss of about 3 on the play. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. It to the 22-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. Play action. Now he's on the move. And now he's going to improvise. And they make the stop at the 44-yard line.
Super play, especially by everybody on that offensive line to create gaps, let the runner burst through to pick up the first.
He makes it to the 42-yard line. He fights forward to about the 39.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 35.
Play fake. Defense bearing down. He's at the 30. They'll bring him down around the 25-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 25. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Tackled outside after a nice pickup.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and 6.
Touchdown, Navy! Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. So an 8-play, 80-yard drive, and a touchdown's a result.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for a defense.
So the score now, 10-7. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll take it from the 2. He got hit hard. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He steps out right around the 34. That's a 3-yard pickup.
This junior wide receiver had absolutely no room to run after the catch. Good play by the defense.
Second down and 6. Ball on their own 34. He's on a run. Good tackle there in space.
This is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
First down. gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's tackled in the open field. It's first and 10. Ball on 34. Slings it. Knocked down of bounds around the 12-yard line. From the 12-yard line, it's first down. Gets out to about the 12-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Got it. And he goes down quickly.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 7. Scrambling around. He's taken down at about the 7-yard line. TCU is down 3 and looking to tie it up. Kicks up, and it's through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23-yard line.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and broke the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 22. We've played a half. This one's all even at 10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
We say it here all the time. It's not always about the X's and the O's. It can be about the Jimmies and the Joes. But I think Jimmy and Joe appear to be pretty evenly matched here. And this might not necessarily be about who has the better athlete, who has the more explosive player. This might come down to which guy maneuvering those X's and O's does so the most wisely.
Well, who's telling Jimmy and Joe where to line up? They gotta know where they're supposed to go. So I think it is important. And the coaches, sometimes you got to break character. You know, sometimes you know you're a predominantly run team, and that's what you do, and you're going to line up and pound it. But sometimes you face a good defense that's playing really well that they're not going to allow you to do that. And sometimes you got to get a little bit out of character. And I think which offense or which defense can take a few chances and get rewarded for those chances, come up on the plus side of it, create a big turnover, set your offense up on the right side. Why don't you dial up one of those trick plays you got in your bag that you haven't used in a while that you think might could work and might could maybe bust open this game and give you a little bit of separation.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. And he's tackled at the 24. To the tailback, incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth down.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Clip it. Receiving team.
He showed a good burst there. From their own 46-yard line, first down. Gets to about the 47-yard line. The catch and look out. He's knocked out of bounds around the 43-yard line.
He looks pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 43. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33. Quick strike, and he drops it. Here's a quick throw. So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
Made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. It out to maybe the 7-yard line. Well, let's see what they do here. It's third and goal from the 6. Setting up blockers, your running back's got it on the screen. He makes the PAT, a 9-play, 55-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 17-10. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. TCU's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
And he's taken down
at about the 37-yard line.
Down he goes at the 36. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle at the 47-yard line. They'll get him in the backfield.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
From their own 43-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. Throws a dart to the right. Nice catch. First down, and he's knocked out. That's a great tackle at the 29-yard line. He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 13.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
He's into the open field. He takes it right side for a good game.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
They try to get a head start there.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12. He's tackled at the 2.
Defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
From the 6-yard line, second down. So at the end of the third quarter, TCU in front, 17-10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
Let's see how the quarterback handles this one. It's third and goal from the 7. He's scrambling. And they make the stop at about the 3-yard line. he's scrambling. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. Navy to kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Got a man in and out of his hands.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over him.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. They'll bring him down at the 33-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
And he's level at the 33. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. Pitches back, and they get him in the backfield for a loss.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. He fights forward to about the 39. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. He's taken down at about the 43-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. The option keeper gets him to maybe 3 yards. Just under three to go in regulation. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And he is drilled at the 13. Down midshipman. And he hits the PAT. A six play, 60-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running room.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 25. TCU's ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
No, they've not played up to their expectations at all. But they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Complete and he stopped immediately. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Second. Pulls in the pass and steps out. Him hard at the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. Just under two to go in the game. Fires out to his receiver, and he tackles him hard at the 46. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets it out to the wideout, and he's got the first. And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line. Got it. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. TCU just took their first time out. It's second down, seven to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Scrambling around. Brought down around the 22-yard line.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
This is the eighth play of this drive. A bullet over the middle. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. Yeah. extra point to tie this game up. They didn't snap the ball in time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Under a minute left. And he adds the extra point. Just under a minute left in the fourth quarter, and this game hasn't failed to disappoint. It's a tie ball game. We're locked at 24s. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 23. Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
You got to hurry here, but you don't want to rush things and make a critical mistake.
This is what it all comes down to, right? This is why we love this game. Across the middle, intercepted. And he's taken down around the 23-yard line.
It was time for somebody to step up and make a play. And boy, did the defense come through. Now they've got a chance to take the lead. That was huge.
We've got a first and 10, ball on the 23. Fires that quickly to the tailback. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Well, that's the end of regulation, and this game is still unsettled, so we're going to overtime. Back to the action here, and we get ready for overtime. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. It's second and 5 here. Ball on the 20. At about the 17-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. He makes the PAT. It's first and 10. Ball on the 25. Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete. In trouble. He zips it out to the left. Game-winning interception. Unbelievable. A great game here today. In a tight one. Navy 31, TCU 24. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.